Welcome back, dear viewers, and you are still watching The Breakfast Show. And in this segment of our program, we will talk about Nile for Peace Conference, which was organized by African civil society representatives. The conference issued a document calling for the postponement of the Grand Renaissance Dam. The document sets guidelines for resolving the dam crisis, preventing any potential conflict over rivers in Africa. And to shed more light on the importance of this conference, we are joined over the phone by Dr. Hassan Shaaban. He is a political analyst. Good morning, sir, and happy Ramadan.
Good morning, people. Happy Ramadan.
So, sir, as I've just mentioned, that African civil society representatives organized a peace, a Nile for Peace conference. What is the significance of this conference?
Actually, Egypt has been trying for so long to reach a formula to keep, or to preserve the rights of all the countries that actually share the River Nile.
Yes.
And the whole idea is that the River Nile is a bond that connects Ethiopia and Egypt together. We would like this river to be a binding thing forever. We would like to share development, we would like to share projects, but not on the behalf of the Egyptians, who are getting a fixed share of the River Nile, because, we're not a rainy country. We depend solely on the River Nile, and the River Nile is Egypt, full stop. So without the River Nile, there is no Egypt. Or, actually, we don't like the idea of us facing a starvation or a thirst issue. So this conference actually is dealing with this issue to try to find a way that actually makes the three countries have a fair deal, actually. So let's keep our fingers crossed.
So, sir, you participated in one of negotiations related to the dam issue. Can you tell us about your experience in this issue?
Well, actually, Ethiopia have every right
yes.
to develop. I mean, we do not deny this. This is a right for the Ethiopian people, brothers in Africa, and we would like, we wish them all the best. But again, we have our own plans, and we
yes.
have, a historical, documents that actually states that Egypt have a fair share of this River Nile. And we depend solely on the Blue Nile that comes from Tana Lake in Ethiopia. So actually, we would like to reach a point where we can control the discharge of the water from Tana Lake to all the three countries. Egypt requires a certain amount of water, and Sudan as well requires the same amount. So we would like Ethiopia to reason and try to prolong the duration of filling the lake behind the dam, especially the dam actually the original design was a lot smaller than what happened later on. But this is the whole, it is the full right of Ethiopia to change and alter the size of the dam. But again, we cannot survive without our share of water, because this is the minimum amount of water that we require in Egypt. So I think in the near future, all the East African countries should, work together and try to find a modern way and a way to control all the water resources to reach a good management, water management system, like sharing a satellite that can control the world, you know, give the and have the data for all the rainfall in East Africa, all the amounts, reserve amounts behind all the dams and reservoirs, and orchestrate all the dams and the reservoirs in the area to make sure that none of the countries that share this river actually is exposed to any thirst or a water famine.
Yes, one final question, Dr. Hassan. Yesterday, President Fattah Sisi received the Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov, and the Foreign Minister affirmed his country's firm position in rejecting any harm to Egypt's historical water rights, as well as rejecting unilateral measures in this regard. How do you read international reactions in general to the dam issue?
We didn't take the issue all the way to the United Nations or to the court in Lahai, Justice Court in Lahai. We are trying to make all the countries that are connected with us with strong ties to understand our opinion. Russia, you know, during the Soviet Union era, was our partner in building the Aswan Dam, the Hai Dam. And they are fully aware of the, you know, the details of the and the geology of the area, the River Nile geology basin area. So I think it is very important for us to get a country, a superpower like Russia, to understand our point of view, because we don't want this issue to escalate to a non-return point. You know, we are brothers in Africa, and we would like to solve our problems in a friendly way. There is no point in escalating problems. It's, you know, water is life, and everybody should understand this. This is, we cannot risk or gamble the future of Egypt. Full stop.
Dr. Hassan Shaban, political analyst, thank you, sir, for being with us. Have a good day. And by that, dear viewers, we come to the end of today's edition of The Breakfast Show. I'm Sheena Adel, and I was joined today by my colleague Amal Mukhtar. Thank you for watching.